Yo, what's up YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to give you guys a breakdown of the four lessons that I've learned after working in cybersecurity full-time for 1 year. If you're new to the channel, my name is Ben and I make videos about cybersecurity and my experience and journey throughout the industry. So if you're not subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and join the family. Also, if you enjoyed this video and find some value in it, go ahead and drop me a like for the YouTube algorithm. It really helps out my channel. And if you want some more short form content and more lifestyle content, feel free to follow me on Instagram and TikTok at CyberWithBen. So at number one, we're going to have the importance of basics and having an understanding of basic IT concepts and networking fundamentals, because those are going to be so important when you start off your career in cybersecurity. Having a solid understanding of things like IP addresses, the flow of data, so different like TCP, UDP, understanding different protocols and what they do. These are going to be so important for you to be able to use different tools in cybersecurity and understand how data is flowing, so you actually understand what's going on and what you're doing. So if you're using a SIM, you understand how these different logs are integrated. You understand how the data is flowing through the SIM. You understand how certain alerts are being triggered and things of that nature. In addition to that, having a basic understanding of different operating systems like Windows and Linux, and being able to do some system administration tasks associated with those operating systems are also going to be a huge plus for you going into your first role. So these include tasks like user management, permissions and updates, patching, things of that nature. And lastly, as part of these basics, having an understanding of different cybersecurity concepts and knowing how to use different tools like EDRs, different SIMs, intrusion detection systems, and also understanding the basics of cybersecurity, like maybe encryption, knowing how a firewall works, things of that sort, they're going to be so helpful for you to be able to start contributing and start understanding how things work when you start entering your first organization in a cybersecurity role. So one piece of advice for you is that if you're someone who is studying for your different certifications or you're learning the basics of IT and cybersecurity, definitely don't kind of rush through this process. Really take your time and understand each of these concepts, because when it comes time for you to start your first role in cybersecurity, these concepts are going to come in handy when understanding how these things work in your first role. If you're someone who is new to cybersecurity and don't know exactly where to get started, I want to introduce you to today's video sponsor, Southern New Hampshire University. Southern New Hampshire University has one of the largest accredited nonprofit online degree offerings in the country. And I want to talk to you guys about their online bachelor's in cybersecurity program. Within this program, you'll learn so many different skills that apply to a cybersecurity role today. Some of these skills include understanding hacker tradecraft and how to respond to them with incident response skills. You'll learn how to solve complex cybersecurity problems by applying systems thinking and adversarial thinking to your skill set. You'll learn how to apply security principles and practices to evaluate a system on its risks and threats. You'll also learn how to make informed judgments on computing practice based on legal and ethical principles. You can choose to study the general track of the cybersecurity bachelor's degree or add one of the two career-focused concentrations to your program, data analytics fundamentals and project management fundamentals. SNHU is radically affordable and their tuition rates are some of the lowest in the nation. Go to snhu.edu/bentrong. I'll leave a link in the description below to check out what the average current salary is for someone with a bachelor's in cybersecurity, and also to get free information on the program itself. So my second lesson is going to be about imposter syndrome, and this is actually an issue that a lot of people in technology, and I'm sure a bunch of different industries, face when you first start off your role in cybersecurity. And also, people who are even more tenured in cybersecurity also continue to face this issue. So for those of you guys who don't know, imposter syndrome is like the feeling that you really don't belong somewhere, or you're kind of like the black sheep out of the entire group. And that is something that a lot of beginners face, because when you first get into the industry, that I experienced myself, you're surrounded by people that already know what they're doing, who have years of experience. And as someone who is brand new, it feels as if you're kind of out of place and you really don't belong. But a few things that I did to combat this issue is to really take it day by day and focus on my own development. So as long as I'm learning something new, whether it be something really small or even big, that is one step in the right direction. And that's really the mindset that helped me grow out of this imposter syndrome phase in the beginning part of my career. So another aspect that helped me combat imposter syndrome is going to be after that beginning beginning phase of when you first start your role. So in the beginning of your role, you usually have some form of like training period. It usually lasts around 3 to 6 months. But after that beginning phase is over, you start to really get up to speed. You understand what kind of work you do and how it impacts the overall organization. And you actually are able to start to contribute. And that's what really helped me with my imposter syndrome, is being able to make an impact and having an understanding of how my work impacts the overall security posture of the organization. And sometimes as people working in cybersecurity and technology, we get so stuck in the weeds and the day-to-day that sometimes we neglect to understand the impact of our work and how it affects the organization and its customers. So having a good understanding of the big picture and having that perspective is something that is so helpful for me as someone who was beginning in cybersecurity, to be able to have some fulfillment and have some joy in the impact of my work in my day-to-day tasks. Lesson number 3 is going to be team collaboration and not neglecting your soft skills. Now, as beginners in cybersecurity, I understand it's so important to start developing your technical skills, but at the same time, I think one of the most underrated skills in cybersecurity and technology in general is going to be your soft skills. And when I talk about soft skills, I'm talking about things like being able to hold a conversation, being able to approach strangers, being someone easy to work with in a team setting. These are going to be some invaluable skills that really you can't teach except throughout experience and your time in the industry. So when you're looking to get into cybersecurity, definitely don't neglect your soft skills, because in cybersecurity, you're always talking, you're always collaborating with different people from different teams. So for example, if you're speaking or presenting to C-suite level executives, maybe you want to use more layman's terms or high level terms that they'll understand in terms of business and strategy. On the other hand, if you're talking to someone who is more on the technical side, maybe you'll use more technical jargon and things of that sort. Having strong soft skills is going to be so important for you in terms of growing in cybersecurity, because it'll make you a better person to work with, leading to more promotions, and then also open some potential doors and opportunities that you might not know about through networking. And lastly, at lesson 4, we have the continuous learning aspect of cybersecurity. And this is something that I quickly learned about as soon as I got into cybersecurity, is that cybersecurity is so vast and there's so many different niches and teams and departments in cybersecurity that use different tools, different languages, different frameworks. There's just so much to learn in cybersecurity. And on top of that, cyber threats are continuously evolving and changing their different TTPs. So it's going to be up to you, especially if you're someone who is working in those technical roles, to stay up to date and to continue developing your skills even outside of work and outside of work hours. So if you're someone who is looking to get into cybersecurity, I highly recommend, first of all, having a genuine interest in cybersecurity and IT concepts. And secondly, be willing to continue to develop your skills outside of work, which is going to be so important for you to have throughout your entire cybersecurity career to stay updated and stay sharp. So overall, those are going to be my 4 lessons after working my first full year in cybersecurity. And honestly, guys, I can say if you're someone looking to break into the industry, and honestly, I can say that I have a great time working in cybersecurity so far. I've learned so many new things. I've met some great and smart people, and I wouldn't recommend it enough, especially if you're someone looking to break into the industry right now. If you found some value in this video, go ahead and drop me a like and subscribe to the channel if you're new. A lot of you guys are watching this video and aren't subscribed, so please join the family. Also, if you want some more short form content and more lifestyle content, feel free to follow me on Instagram and TikTok at CyberWithBen. With that being said though, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.